What's happening, guys? Keith here with another Impact Wrestling Review. So today we're going to take a look at the November 24th edition of Explosion. The feature matchup here was Josh Alexander versus Matt Sydal. This match took place during the August tapings at the Rebel Complex. Josh Alexander seems to be a crowd favorite, at least over in Canada. We've seen him a handful of times on Explosion. We've also seen him on the Twitch specials along with the One Night Onlys. Surprised they never did anything with him as far as bringing him on the flagship show Impact. I mean, especially during when they were in Canada, at least, as he's a crowd favorite, it would have made sense to at least bring him on a couple times. For some reason during this match, Josh was calling commentary by himself, so that never really helps much. I mean, just there's only so much you can do calling a match by yourself. Start the match, Alexander gives Sydal a shot to the face. Matt Sydal does what he normally does, rolls out of the ring. I guess he was hiding underneath the ring. Josh goes to find him. He's searching under the ring. Sydal comes out from the side, blindsides him, and Sydal goes to work. We go to commercial, come back, and the two are going back and forth. Sydal goes for a spinning heel kick, but he gets caught by Alexander, and then he hits him with a backbreaker. Crowd really getting into the match. We got a whole "This is wrestling" chant breaking out. Alexander goes up top. He jumps at Matt Sydal. Matt Sydal counters it, hitting him with a jumping knee. Sydal then kicks Alexander and hits him with that move that he spins. He rocks his opponent and then spins him down for the victory. I'm not sure exactly what the move is called, but neither did Josh. So if you guys know what that move is called, let me know. I actually looked at another review where he used the finisher, and that person wasn't sure as well. Maybe it doesn't even have a name. But it was a decent match. It really never got out of first gear. Lasted about 5 minutes. Again, solo commentary kind of takes away from the match. Usually with Don calling the match, he always has something funny or interesting to say. At least putting somebody over. But again, Josh by himself. Only so much you can do. And then we had Around the Ring with Jake Crist. I believe this was recorded in the Melrose Ballroom in New York City. This was apparently the third time that Jake has been on Around the Ring. Josh asks Jake about imitating Sami Callihan. This was pretty much the whole thing they talked about. Jake says that he is the mini draw, and he says he is 10% of the game, and Sami is 90%. He says it's the dynamic they have. And then Josh mentions that Dave always looks irritated when he's doing it. And Jake says that him and Sami always try to do things to get under Dave's skin. So that makes sense. At this point, Don Callis walks up and he asks Jake why he's in a seat, because apparently they were going to record. You could hear the crowd start getting into it. Then they talk about them going to a Bengals game on November 25th. So that was at least relevant since this episode came, well, technically it was supposed to air on the 24th, but Sami and Jake are apparently Bengals fans, and Dave is a Browns fan, so we take a look back at their victory from Bound for Glory, and that was it. So it was pretty short. I don't know if this was because of time constraints, or they really had nothing left to talk about, because Josh seemed to be having trouble with that at the beginning. I really think they need to do what they do with the press pass, but do it here where fans can kind of send questions into the wrestlers or to Impact, whatever, and have your question aired here. It might help get people to tune in to see if their questions asked. But again, these are taped in advance, so it's kind of hard to do that. Hopefully, if Impact gets a new TV deal, maybe they'll actually do something with Explosion, because I think it could definitely be used as a secondary show. And we have our classic match, which, again, it's something that they could just get rid of. Just do a small GWN flashback. Say you can watch the rest of the match on the Global Wrestling Network. Something like that. But this match was from Final Resolution 2008. Kurt Angle versus Rhino with Mick Foley as the special enforcer. Apparently, they held two Final Resolution events in 2008. One in January and one in December. I was just trying to get a backstory on it, and I was like, none of those matches happened on this show. But that was from the January one. This one took place in December. But apparently, I guess if Kurt Angle didn't win the match, that his contract would be ripped up. And then if he won, he got to face Jeff Jarrett, I believe, at Genesis. Crowd was split 50-50 between Rhino and Kurt Angle. Rhino did start off in control. Then that transitioned over to Kurt. But it really had a slow pace. It just seemed like it wasn't working well together. Kurt was just trying to wear Rhino down with regular ground wrestling. And the two men end up clotheslining each other. Pace started to pick up a little bit, both men getting shots in. Kurt goes for an Angle slam. Rhino's able to reverse it. Rhino sets up for the gore. Kurt moves out of the way, transitions this into the ankle lock. And as Rhino is trying to reach for the ropes, Kurt pulls him back into the middle. And then we go into commercial, well, at least commercial on the GWN. At this point, we come back from commercial, and the two men are up fighting in the ring. Rhino accidentally gores the ref after Kurt moves out of the way. Foley gets in the ring. Kurt leaves the ring to grab a chair. Foley tells him to get rid of the chair or else he's DQ'd. Kurt drops the chair. And Rhino ends up rolling Kurt up, but he only gets a two count. Rhino hits a superplex. That gets a near fall. Al Snow comes out and slaps Foley. Foley chases him out of the ring. Kurt grabs the chair, hits Rhino, hits the Angle slam, and Kurt wins. So this was kind of overbooked mess. I guess there was some sort of mystery person surrounding this match previously, which I guess turned out to be Al Snow. So, yeah, it was overbooked and with interference, and that was always one of the downfalls of past matches they did, was a lot of outside interference and overbooking, obviously. And then our recap from last week's episode of Impact was the 5-on-5 match from the Thanksgiving Day episode. This, I didn't realize how long this match was. It was probably a good 20 minutes, at least what they showed. And then they did cut out the best part when Scarlett came out. So I don't know why they did that, but whatever. Regardless, it was a fun match. It was followed by KM, Desmond Xavier, Kikitara, and Alicia versus Eli Drake, Jake Crist, Rohit Raju, Glenn Gilberti, and Katarina. And Glenn Gilberti was forced to wear the turkey suit. You can check out my full review on the channel. It is available. But yeah, no, a fun match. It was a decent show overall. Like I said, I just kind of wish they'd get rid of the classic match and put another relevant match there. But again, nothing I can do about that. Hopefully, like I said, once they, or if they get a new TV deal, maybe they'll actually utilize Explosion for more than what it is used for right now. But that's all I really have for you guys. I will be back tomorrow with my Impact review. And until then, thanks for checking out my video. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye. Did you like that video? If so, click here to check out more great content. Thank you for supporting the Clock Cleaners Podcast.